Hey everybody, Wendy here from Cinnamon Sweet Shop. Today I'm going to be making some almond chocolate chip shortbread cookies. And you can make this gluten-free just by substituting the flour to a gluten-free flour. So what you will need is flour. Now I'm using a whole wheat pastry flour, but as I said, you can use a gluten-free flour. You're also going to need some chopped almonds, salt, almond extract. I use my Earth Balance vegan buttery sticks. However, you could use unsalted butter, some organic sugar. Now we're going to be using two different kinds of chocolate chips. I'm using semi-sweet chocolate chips, and I'm using some dark chocolate chips and just a little bit of cinnamon. Don't forget, all the measurements for these ingredients are at the link underneath this video. In my mixer with the paddle attachment, I'm going to mix together the softened butter and the sugar. I'm going to just blend this for about 3 minutes until it's real creamy. Scrape down the bowl and then add in the almond extract. And then continue to blend this just for another 30 seconds. In a medium-sized bowl, combine the flour, cinnamon, salt, 1/3 cup of the chopped almonds, and all of the semi-sweet chocolate chips. Now, combine the flour mixture into the butter mixture and just mix it for about 20 to 30 seconds just until it forms a dough consistency. This is what your dough should look like when it's mixed. It should form a nice sticky mass. I have a lined baking pan with a silicone mat. You could use parchment paper as well. You could either use a tablespoon or just eyeball it, which is what I'm going to be doing. And form 1 tablespoon size balls. Place them about 1.5 inches apart. Using the bottom of a flat glass, I'm just going to flatten each cookie out. With the remainder of the almonds, I'm just going to place them on top. I like to push them in as well so they'll stick. Maybe a couple, 2 or 3 chocolate chips on top to make it look a little nicer. These will be baked in a 350-degree oven for 10 minutes, then rotate the pan around and bake for another 10 to 12 minutes. They should be a light golden brown in color when they're done. Melt down your chocolate chips. These would be the dark chocolate chips. And when your cookies are baked, these are how mine came out. I'm going to just dip half of them in, or not even half, but just to get the tips or part of it covered in chocolate. Let the cookies set, serve when you're ready to serve them. Don't forget, for this recipe and all my other recipes, stop at my website, cinnamonsweetshop.com. Subscribe to this YouTube channel for much, much, much more. See you in my next video.